Everyone, we're back today to talk POS hardware again. Today, I wanted to cover barcode scanners. They serve a variety of purposes for different types of businesses and are often a really important piece of the POS puzzle. Since its first implementation in 1970, the basic function of the barcode has remained largely the same, with some updated features and capabilities, of course. Almost every business, big and small, uses barcodes for SKU and UPC numbers, inventory management, and facilitating transactions. Thus, barcode scanners are a vital tool for businesses as they provide faster, more accurate, and more efficient data entry and POS processing. Barcode scanners work much like the human eye. They use light to decipher empty versus filled spaces on a barcode. This information is captured, then delivered into the processor. The processor converts it into a series of binary code that communicates with the software to relay what item it's representing. The technology used to capture these barcodes continues to evolve to respond to businesses' demands and consumer needs. While they use different types of sensors, cameras, and lasers to capture, they all perform the same basic task. But how exactly do barcode scanners work? And how can business owners determine which are the right ones for their needs? In this video, I'll give you an overview of the basics and dive into some more common specific options of barcode scanners. So first, how do these things work anyway? Barcode scanners capture the reflected light and decode it into a numerical sequence of binary code. Traditionally, barcode scanners use laser or LCD light. By capturing the black and white pattern on a barcode, they process and relay that information back to the POS or computer connected to them. Sophisticated types of scanners can read a whole barcode at once, while more traditional and basic models have to be dragged across in order to physically scan the code. Today, we're seeing an increasing use of camera technology for barcode capture. These barcode scanners convert the shapes of lines, squares, and numbers into binary code, which can then drop data directly into Excel and POS software. Thus, they're a vital tool for both inventory management and executing sales. So let's go a little bit deeper now. How about the components that make up the scanner? The scanner itself has a three-part system that facilitates the capturing and transferring of the information within the barcode. First is the illumination system. In order to read the code and relay the image back to be processed, the barcode must be illuminated. This used to be done using traditional lamps. Now, barcode scanners will have built-in LED or lasers that act as illuminators. Next is the sensor or lens. A light sensor, called a photodiode, takes the image that is collected and converts it into a corresponding electrical signal. It appears and functions almost as a reverse LED, capturing light and putting it into a wire. Finally, the decoder. Many modern barcode scanners contain decoders built directly into the handle of the gun. These decoders take the binary code that is read by the scanner and convert it into a usable piece of information for whatever software you're using. Some scanners will require the use of a keyboard wedge, which acts as an external decoder between the actual scanner hardware and the computer. There are also many different types of scanners. Scanner capabilities and prices differ greatly. The cheapest pen scanners on eBay are less than $10, while some supermarket-style scanners can cost several thousand dollars. Generally, the more you pay for your scanner, the more capable it will be to read imperfectly printed or displayed barcodes. For example, if there are slight blemishes and misprints on a barcode, cheaper models might have problems reading the information. In addition, more basic models require closer contact and alignment and won't be able to scan cell phone QR codes at all. Some of the more basic scanners are 1D linear scanners or laser scanners. 1D refers to a type of barcode. Using UPC and SKU numbers, they hold up to a few dozen characters, requiring more letters and numbers as more information is added. 1D linear scanners are often gun-shaped and have been used since the mid-1970s. Using lasers as a light source to relay the image back into the scanner, they require close proximity to the barcode, a few inches to a few feet. There are also 1D image scanners. These use imaging technology instead of lasers to capture barcodes. This charge-centered device uses hundreds of light sensors, and it functions similarly to a digital camera. They are technologically superior to linear scanners as they are faster, better at reading poorly printed or damaged barcodes, and require less direct distance for scanning. However, 1D scanners cannot read barcodes that are displayed on phone screens because they don't reflect back the image. There are also 2D scanners. With two-dimensional reading capabilities, these scanners read 2D barcodes that are both horizontal and vertical. This allows them to contain more information, in this case up to 2,000 characters. They also implement shapes and patterns such as squares and hexagons. As such, 2D barcode scanner captures contain much more information such as URLs, loyalty programs, images, voice recordings, and more. But how does a 2D scanner work? They function like a modern camera technology to capture the code, then decode it with an algorithm to relay the information back to the computer. Of course, 2D scanners can also read and function for 1D types of barcodes. Most importantly though, 2D image readers can capture barcodes from cell phones. This functionality is a massive asset for companies that use mobile ticketing or email and SMS coupons. Aside from the scanners themselves, there are some additional pieces of hardware worth considering. Different types of scanner hardware are available according to individual needs, such as mobile use, durability, handheld scanners, stationary devices, price range, scanner range, and more. First are those scanner pens I mentioned earlier. These are the most basic and least expensive barcode scanners. They look like oversized pens and require direct contact with the actual barcode. Scanner pens can be plugged directly into a laptop USB device to function. While they're durable and less prone to environmental hazards like dust and dirt, they're much slower and are really only useful for very low scanning needs. Next, portable wireless scanner guns can be very useful for situations that need mobility. Do you need a scanner to use for inventory in a warehouse or large retail floor? Having the ability to move around with a scanner can be a huge advantage in these contexts. For warehouses and hardware stores, there are rugged scanners that guarantee protection against drops and other forms of wear and tear. If you have employees moving around frequently and doing inventory in a more industrial environment, then these types of rubberized scanners are a better fit, ensuring longer life and durability. Presentation scanners sit in place and require customers to make contact with the barcode to complete the capture of the information. Presentation scanners make more sense for places that have ticketing, smaller items, or cell phone QR codes. These also make it easier for employee use because they don't have to aim and push a button every time a guest approaches the POS system. Larger operations might have in-counter scanners. These are the big glass laser scanners that you see at the supermarket. Built right into the cashier's counter, they're best suited for conveyor belt situations in which a large number of items are being scanned in a row. Most of the presentation and in-counter models will have omnidirectional capabilities. This means that they use Lissajous curve lasers that read and process barcodes from any angle and direction. The employee or self-checkout customer can simply wave the item barcode past the scanner without having to perfectly line it up. Having this capability facilitates a much faster and easier scanning process and shorter checkout time. Finally, there are smart scanners. The latest development in scanner technology are mini computers that have camera capture capabilities along with memory, Wi-Fi, and internet inventory applications. These portable smart scanners can do end-of-day batches and perform many functions that sync to your POS or inventory management system. They can also use LTE or memory storage to portably scan tickets outside of a concert venue, theme park, or vineyard far away from POS terminals. Barcode scanners are an integral part of your company's POS system, and it's important that you take the time to find the best fit. Reach out to Corona POS today, and we'll work with you to optimize your inventory management and streamline your checkout processes with the best scanner for your business. Click the link in the description to schedule a call with one of our product specialists so you can find out what fits best your needs. For more retail advice and guides, subscribe to our blog and channel, and thanks for coming by today.